What's new in accessibility at Google? Hi everyone, I'm Alexander Hauerslev Jensen, Accessibility Program Manager here at Google. Welcome back to another episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. Today, we'll be sharing some exciting product updates for Pixel, Android, Chrome, Workspace, and Google Wallet. To kick things off, an announcement for Pixel users. Guided Frame just got a whole lot better. For those unfamiliar, Guided Frame helps blind and low vision users take better photos by providing verbal and audio cues, high contrast animation, and haptic feedback that confirms when the subject is in frame. The latest round of updates include improved AI object recognition, which has expanded to include pets and objects in addition to faces. This means that whether you're taking a picture of your friend, your new puppy, or a dessert at a restaurant, this feature will provide verbal guidance so you can center your subject before auto-capturing the image. Guided Frame also comes with improved face angle guidance, which helps you prompt to tilt your face up or down, pan left to right, before the camera auto-captures the image. It also lets you know if your lighting is low so you can find a better spot. Another update is intelligent face filtering in group photos, which lets the camera focus on the intended group of people in a photo instead of those who may unintentionally have walked into frame. If you have the Talkback screen reader turned on, Guided Frame will be automatically turned on as well. And you can also turn on the feature directly from your camera setting. Both support Pixel 6 or higher. In other Pixel news, the Magnifier app, co-designed with the low vision community, also got an upgrade that leverages the AI. In addition to helping people see things that are far away or that are difficult to read, the Magnifier app can now be used to search for and zoom right into specific words in your surroundings, like finding gluten-free items on a menu or gate numbers at an airport. Just snap a photo and start searching. You can also use the new picture-in-picture format to see both the bigger context of what you're looking at, along with details on your screen without losing your place. Perfect for perusing behind-the-counter options at the deli. For more details on how to use the Magnifier app, be sure to check out our latest video, Get to Know the Newly Updated Magnifier App on Pixel. Shifting to broader Android updates, we're excited to talk about Live Caption, a feature which provides real-time captions for a wide range of audio sources on Android devices. In addition to being supported in 7 new languages, Korean, Polish, Portuguese, Russian, Simplified Chinese, Turkish, and Vietnamese, we also launched Expressive Captions, a feature that brings emotions to captions. Expressive Captions not only tells you what someone is saying, but how they're saying it, by displaying things like emphasis, volume, and background noises. If a person is shouting, for example, the caption text may be displayed in all caps, or if an audience is applauding, Expressive Caption may show cheers and applause. Expressive Captions is available in the US, in English, on any Android device running Android 14 and above that has Live Caption. We also released automatically generated captions in Workspace. This means that when users upload a video to Google Drive, captions are automatically generated, creating a transcript of your video. Automatically generated captions are supported in English, with plans to expand to other languages in the future. In Lookout, our app that uses your phone's camera to recognize and describe details about the world around you, we are improving the accuracy of image mode. Now powered by Gemini, image mode is giving users more detailed descriptions of their photos, whether the photos are taken with the app or pulled in from other apps, including social media. In addition to more comprehensive descriptions, Lookout's image Q&A mode is now available globally, enabling users across the world to ask follow-up questions about their photos. And with Lookout's new auto language detection support, the app can detect and read out text in 35 languages, including Arabic. Finally, we are thrilled to announce that Talkback Android screen reader just got a major upgrade. Powered by Gemini, Talkback now provides even more vivid and informative descriptions of images across your device, whether you're browsing online, checking your photos, or scrolling through social media. Talkback can help like never before. Moving on to ChromeOS, an exciting update for Select to Speak, the feature that enables you to select certain text or parts of the screen to be spoken aloud. This feature now includes AI-powered object character recognition, or OCR, which enables text to speak in Chrome PDF Viewer on documents that were previously inaccessible, like scanned PDFs.
Innovating solutions that connect to and for everyone.
Our final update is for Google Wallet. Recently, we released an update that makes it easier for blind and low vision users to save their state-issued IDs to Google Wallet. Screen reader users will now receive verbal directions on how to position the phone camera to take a clear image of their ID, as well as audio and haptic feedback in real time. That wraps up this episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to check out our YouTube video description where we've linked to more details about many of these updates. If you want to learn more, sign up for our newsletter at g.co/a11y/news or by clicking the link in the description of this video. Until next time. What's new in accessibility at Google?